Now, French President Emmanuel Macron has called for tougher laws to tackle Islamist separatism. The French president highlighted his concerns in a landmark speech in which he spoke of the dangers of a quote-unquote counter-society being formed among the country's 6 million Muslims. Macron's proposals include stricter oversight of schooling, including close monitoring of sports organizations and restricted homeschooling, all as a way to ensure that these do not end up becoming fronts of Islamist teachings. Macron's government will also clamp down on foreign funding of mosques, including the banning of foreign imams from preaching within France.
Il y a, dans cet islamisme radical, puisque c'est le cœur du sujet, abordons-le et nommons-le, une volonté revendiquée, affichée, une organisation méthodique pour contrevenir aux lois de la République et créer un ordre parallèle, ériger d'autres valeurs, développer une autre organisation de la société, séparatiste dans un premier temps, mais dont le but final est de prendre le contrôle complet, celui-ci.
Over the years, homegrown Islamist militancy has confronted France's ethos of or secularism. French officials say that broader non-violent signs of radicalization have become very apparent. They cite refusal of some Muslim men to shake women's hands, for instance, swimming pools that impose alternate time slots for men and women, girls as young as 4 being told to wear full face veils, and a proliferation of madrasa religious schools. But some have accused Macron of trying to repress Islam in France. The president of the Muslims of France Association, Amar Lasfa, argues that there was no need for a new law, saying that applying existing laws could reach the same result. He also took issue with Macron's choice of words. He said, and I quote, "It is a speech that tries to point at a danger, and I do not quite agree. In Islamism, there is the word Islam. And I think he could have talked about extremism or radicalization. One cannot stigmatize all Muslims." With less than 2 years now before the next presidential campaign, Macron is keen not to leave himself open to attacks from conservatives and the French far right. Macron also stresses that Islam and radical Islamism should not be conflated. But at the heart of the matter is the question of what it means to be French in a country with Europe's largest Muslim minority, numbering around 5 million or 7 to 8% of the total population. Over the past 5 years, in attacks by Islamist militants or by lone wolf jihadists, more than 250 people have been killed on French soil.